Well, let's finish the proof. So I think we are left to prove 2 implies 3. So in 2 we say it's surjective, finite and flat. What we are left to prove is they have the same dimension and it's surjective with finite kernel. So we are left to prove kernel F have dimension 0. So actually what we want to prove is that finite fiber . Well, this is reasonable because if you are finite, you know some result on the dimension. For example, finite implies dimension A is equal to dimension B. Sorry, contrary. And if it's injective, for example, in our case, we show it's finite fiber. Well, if it's finite fiber, then dimension of the kernel is 0. Then they have the equal dimension. So I'm a little doubting why we require F to be injective. Well, let me try to think about it. The first thing is, if this is finite, then the kernel will just be of the form of tensor product. And we know finite is preserved by base change. So the kernel will all be isomorphic to the kernel 0, which should be of the form at least locally. So I think you just find the open container. Zero inverse image is still fine. Okay. Let's call it spec E. In this case, we consider fiber 0, it should be of the form . Wow, this one is finite. So morphism from U to T. He is finite generated U mode. This is a finite generated zero model. Okay. The generating base is xi, just enter its identity. Give the generating basis of this k0 mode. goal of this course is to present the basic theory and classification of finite limited group scheme over a perfect field physics case. With this knowledge, it will be possible to study general individual groups and to formulate and understand the significance of the analog of the Bell-Mansion theorem for the p-divisible group of IPYT. For the Bell-Mansion theorem for the p-divisible group of an abelian variety in characteristic P. I mean, for abelian variety with associated with the p-divisible group, and you study the relation with this p-divisible group with the starting abelian variety. Okay. However, there will be no mention of these further lines of the elements in the course, or even p-divisible groups of abelian variety at all. We finish this motivation with some examples of commutative group schemes and finite group schemes thereof. For example, we define the multiplicative group scheme. The multiplication is given by this group scheme is called the multiplicative group scheme. Okay, the homomorphism is given by this multiplicative. We want to know its kernel, which is denoted. This is defined as the fiber product in the following commutative diagram. Thank you.